Okay, morning, Angie Peppers here. I thought I'd take advantage of today to do a segment of what not to do, what you can do to keep deer away, how to nurse your plants back to health, hopefully. I have a lot more plants now. I live in a house. I don't live in a ranch or farm or nothing like that. Got a little very narrow area where I was keeping all, and excuse the mess, I just threw everything everywhere. I used to keep all my pepper plants and everything back here alongside. Surprisingly, I woke up this morning and I guess the deer learned what I had back here and pretty much started eating most of the plants. Put a couple of tomato plants in the ground. I had ordered some seeds from Pepper Joe's. Thanks, Pepper Joe's. Your seeds are amazing. To grow some Roma tomatoes. And as you can see, the deer got to them. I put these in the ground because I wanted to demonstrate how to maintain your plants in the ground as well. Have these in the canister. Got that. Deer got to this one as well. Deer had never come back here before, so it was pretty safe back here. But then again, when you're surrounded by creeks and rivers and deer and all that, you're not gonna be safe. So for right now, we decided to probably, you know, get a greenhouse and perhaps do some sort of fencing. But for right now, this is just rigged, so don't think. I know it looks a little ghetto, but for right now, I'm just don't have the energy right now. My reapers were the only ones that were saved. They're back there. So you can see all these other plants right here. Hopefully y'all can see right there. They were eaten, touched by the deer. So pretty much, they're still, you know, hopefully I can still bring them back. So let's go real quick over here. Like I said, excuse the mess. It looks real messy right now. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. Shout out over there to people out in Kansas, people out in Grand Prairie, people out in the UK. Thanks for subscribing. I have, as you can see here, these are all my habanero pepper plants. And pretty much the deer attacked them pretty good, of course. Obviously, they're not going to touch the peppers. Wish they could, so maybe they wouldn't come back. But so pretty much they attacked every single one of them. I guess by nature, they're not going to eat the entire plant because they know that they're going to regenerate and grow back, and then they will have something to come back to eat to. I had various plants along the yard. The deer pretty much come out here to the street. I've seen them by the trash cans. They never would come out here to the yard. For some reason, I guess they said, you know, she's got a larger variety of plants this time. So they basically started slowly coming onto the yard and started noticing a few flowers, a few plants started getting nibbled. So it's a very good tutorial today because I'll be able to demonstrate the methods that I'm going to use to try to revive and have these plants regenerate. Hopefully I can save them. Trial and error, like I said, retry. I'm pretty upset, but I think I'm kind of getting over it. And excuse me, I'll probably be flashing the terms of these plants because I don't have them all memorized yet. But these that do the flowering, they like to eat these, so I had to move these. They bloom, you know, red, various colors, orange, white. They love these. They love these too. They eat the flowers. You can see here the plants regenerating, so I had to move that one onto the porch. These with the margarita mix, hopefully you guys can see. They got to those too. They love these. I had them kind of right here, and then I guess their necks, when they extend the neck out, they got to these as well. Of course, the habanero peppers, they got to those. They didn't like the peppermint, untouched. My gremlin plants, they didn't like those either. My donkey ears, they didn't like those either. Pretty much they hit up all the pepper plants here. They don't like the fincas. Mother-in-law tongue, they didn't touch those. Form of elephant ear here, they don't like that either. Sorry if I don't have the correct terms right now. They don't like those either. Mother of Thousands or Alligator Tea, they didn't like that one. They didn't get to this one for some reason. My chile piquin, but usually they would have eaten that one too. Asparagus Fern, they didn't like that one. They didn't touch that one. The Bleeding Hearts Vine, doesn't look like they like that one either. They basically maybe left it alone, or maybe they just nibbled it a little bit, but still. And then you got this one, that Gold Star Esperanza. I'm gonna try that one again. Mostly the fincas didn't like, but the other things, like I said, so be careful. The plants that you, the Crown of Christ, they didn't touch that one. That one is supposedly very poisonous. Wish they would have eaten it, maybe they wouldn't come back, but no, I'm kidding. But other than that, like I said, what put them on the porch for now. I'm gonna figure out a better method, probably, like I said, put a greenhouse, put a fence. Been getting a lot of tips and advice. I've been told also to use mothballs, but the only thing with the mothballs, they dissolve rather quickly, and then I think the neighbors have pets that come out. I'd hate for them to get a hold of the mothballs, but still. Also the ivies, if you have ivies, they got to those too. I don't know where I ended up putting it, but they ate that too. So what I did basically was I just got myself a bottle right here, like 32 ounces maybe. Got me 2 tablespoons of Epsom salt. As you know, magnesium has minerals in there, magnesium and sulfur. So what I did, 2 tablespoons, put in this bottle, shake it real, real good. And then I sprayed the leaves, all of it. All of the ones that were affected, all my plants. So what this is going to do, hopefully it'll produce a boost of energy. Also what I did, I tried to go more by organic means. You don't have to, you can do however, Miracle-Gro, whatever. In this case, I'm using this fish emulsion fertilizer. It's kind of stinky, smells a little fishy. It's like fish products and bone and things like that. A lot of nitrogen, phosphates, and things like that. What I did was I got 2 tablespoons, mixed it in a gallon of water, and I just poured a little bit of that to feed these plants a little bit, because right now they're going to start struggling a little bit. Fortunately, the deer left a few leaves, which, as you know, the leaves form as little panels that when the sun hits them, they produce photosynthesis that provide thus the nutrients that pass through the plant. So it's very important that you try to have leaves on these plants. So at least I'm thankful that the deer decided to say, you know, we're going to leave a few plant leaves on there. So hopefully this is going to help. This is my first time where I'm going to try to nurse these plants back to health with the fruit on them. I don't know, maybe if I start seeing them that they're going to start struggling a lot more, what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to pick the peppers off, because as you know, as the plant is producing the fruit, it's kicking a lot of energy and it requires a lot of energy so to help these peppers to mature and to grow. So for right now, I'm going to leave them like this. I'm going to probably do like a 1 or 2 week trial and keep an eye on them. If I start seeing that they're going to start producing new leaf foliage and things like that, I'm going to leave the peppers. If not, I'm just going to have to go ahead and pick them. So again, I am over here in zone 9. I'm over here in San Marcos, Texas, central Texas. This area is known, you know, we have a Purgatory Creek towards the back. We have the San Marcos River. There's a lot of deer here. I could sit out here on the porch and see the deer, but like I said, they would get startled easily with the air conditioning kicking on and things like that. It never really fazed me that they were going to actually walk back there, but you know, valuable lesson learned. For those of you that garden, that do gardening, even if you're a beginner or you just have a love for plants, you could probably try to empathize with me and understand how it feels to get attacked and then have to start over. But that's what we do. This is, you know, what I'm going to do is to try to, like I said, revive these plants. And then we'll go from there. So you guys just keep an eye out there on your plants and gardens and things. Like I said, I'm going to try different methods of trying, you know, I'm going to get a greenhouse to protect the babies, of course, first and most all. and then probably do like some sort of fencing or something to deter and keep the deer away. I've heard all kinds of things, people urinating on their yards, buying chemicals at Lowe's and things like that. I'm going to try to figure it out which method works better. There's not one method that's better than the other. You just, I guess, just got to experiment. So again, I wanted to do this segment just to talk to you guys and let y'all know what's going on and the statuses. Like I said, the only thing that was not touched was a reaper. So that's because they were towards back the end of the porch, so they weren't able to get there. So just shoot me some emails. You subscribe. I have a Facebook page as well, Angie Peppers. Thanks for those that are watching and subscribing. Any tips, any advice helps. But like I said, it's a learning process. I'm not an expert. We learn by error. So I think that's the best way. So you guys take it easy, and I'll see y'all next time.